I got my own big brother now today with a very renowned man. He don't work for the UN. If I say I talk about him right now, believe me, we're not going to be able to do this conversation here. Mr. Shamsuddin.
Yes.
Can you introduce yourself?
My name is Alhaji Shamsuddin Cole from the Mountain God Fullertown area. I work with the UN for 22 years. I even get there before Kande, but God bless the man so much that he superseded with all the other Africans that were working at the UN. He has been, apart from Kofi Annan, he's the next highest African that has ever worked at the UN. So it's a pride for me to be part of this movement.
Wow. Wow. So you see, if the man don't work at the UN, don't move that position there. It's easy for them to do something as alone.
The thing is not that the man working at the UN. We all working at the UN. But in position was very exceptional. This is the man when we see the entire world, when he retire, when he give a retirement speech at the UN, the first person we stand up, we applaud him, was President Obama. Then followed by the Chancellor of Germany and the Prime Minister of England. This shows the caliber of person where he be. You see, we need people that can produce that salon now. Salon need as much help as you can get. This is the man where he can open any doors. I know it. I have seen it doing it. He has done it before. I mean, this man go a conference at Geneva where I attend. When he walked in, I was proud to be a Sierra Leonean. Honestly. So I know say, believe me, the difficulties we're going to go through now. With Kande Yonkel as president, I don't get any doubts that it will make Salon be one of the best countries in Africa.
It's coming from an experienced man and who has been in the UN, and if he says this about Kande Yonkel, it's a go.
One thing I want to tell my brother Sierra Leonean and my sister Sierra Leonean, let us not make a mistake. This man is a blessing for our country. Foreigners, and they tell me that we work with the UN, they call me, they tell me that, say this man is a blessing. If we leave this man, we will go back another 20 years.
So you want to say Kande Yonkel is the Messiah for Sierra Leone right now?
I don't want to call him the Messiah, because that's a religious title. But believe me, he's the Savior.
Savior.
He's the Savior of Sierra Leone.
Thank you very much. I love that word, Savior.
You're welcome, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you for the patience. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you when you think that you are alive in my life.
Front page film studio, and we get with gentleman here. What is your name, sir?
Mohamed Lamine Konde.
Mr. Konde, what is your role in this movement?
Well, me own at this movement, one me at the chairman for the KKY DMV, Washington DC, Naya. And that in a major role where they play.
You say KKYD movement. Some people they don't know what's in a KKYD movement.
Okay, now, Kande Kole Yomikela movement, now the District of Columbia, Maryland, and Virginia, okay. Collectively in the metropolitan area.
You can tell the audience, what is Kande Yomikela?
Well, Kande Yomikela, first of all, I put and say, now a very competitive man, a very resilient fellow. Now, a man will really, really get the experience of what is alone they look for right now. Now, a man will get compassion for humanity. And if you get compassion for humanity, now we need us alone right now. We have tried many, many different set of people there. But Kande seem to just get the knack. What needs to be done? How it should be done? Now, a people's person. That's Kande. He's a very humble person.
You talk about experience. I mean, we don't get a lot of people that we don't come under the leadership of being the president's Nasalo. They come with experience. We vote for them. We say this now, experienced people, them, then they're outside of the world. Kande Yomikela, you talk about experience. How will you able to know Kande Yomikela experience go do something Nasalo?
And very easy. Go back on Facebook, go back on track record on other African countries there. Go on in track record in UNIDO, go on in track record what you don't do in Akichom and different parts of Salon. And plus, if we judge leaders based on other leaders, now like what the Creole man say, if they take other person belt, you beat other person. In America, what make America great? We continue. They bring new people, and then new people, and then they make a change. Look at Obama. The White House was great, but now the White House is not great. But now, as you say, the next White House might be great. So Kande Yomikela, like anybody else, in get experience. Are we going to refuse to try his experience because somebody else in your experience don't make Salon go into demise? So Kande Yomikela, in get that experience, they will not just for say, well, okay, now that ex-president or Y president don't disappoint with people them, we're not going to try a young, energetic, 59-year-old man will get a track record where any Sierra Leonean can be proud of. Not just proud as an educated man, but to say, hands-on, this is what we've done. Hands-on, this is what Kande Yomikela have done. See, that's the basic thing.
Tell me, because from we own experience, we know say Kande Yomikela be there under SLPP, and today we see say they go on your own separate movements.
Yes.
Any reason?
Yes. Yes, very simple. We cannot live in the old age. We cannot live, we make allegiance to a political party. We must have we allegiance to Mama Salon. What in Ompuel Salon? When they say you know APC, you know for left APC. When they say you know SAPP, you know for left SAPP. And in reality, it is not whether it's APC or SAPP, it's whether it's Sierra Leone. So when can they left SAPP? Now because they see a demise of a political party that you were once proud of. But now we see a renegade movement. We see paupers. We see people who don't get respect for the SAPP constitution. And this man, the man will believe in planning, program, implementation, and production. So if SAPP not they produce, why should it be there? When Sierra Leone Day in this quagmire of economic demise, you know, it don't make any sense. So we should not have allegiance to a party. Have allegiance to your country.
Okay, thank you so much. And if I can make a summary, Kande Yomikela left because he not see himself like SLPP gets a vision to the country.
Well, so, SLPP don't have a visionary idea anymore. It seems like they count out to whatever the normal culture dictates today in a Salon. So, and this man is a visionary. And when you're not a visionary, you excite yourself for continue.
Okay, we'll go hear more from and see if they on the way for camp.
Yes.
And we'll go hear in your voice and tell me who that in be.
Definitely.
What you plan for do for Salon.
Definitely.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very
Thank
much.
Thank you
sir.
Very much.
Send them to them. Send them.
Kesa.
No bad, how do you
With the record from Front Street Film Studio, a local TV station where we get the DMV Naya.
Okay.
Where they try for cover any aspirants who come to America for do something.
Okay.
And I know say you come here today for support this man who we all the wait for see.
Yes, sir.
You understand?
Yes,
I mean, you can tell me about yourself.
Me na Obai Kabia.
Okay.
Who shall I first start? I start with me parents.
Okay.
Me daddy na been the late paramount chief by Koblo Patiba Nana Losa, Madam Pachifdom. Me mama na been the late paramount chief, Madam Ella Koblo Gulama na Moyamba. So me na the first boy pikin. And we did Naya seriously for can support we brother Kande Yunkela. You know, now I come for support. Yeah.
What is the reason where you feel say you devour yourself for support this man today?
My God, who's how you all start? Now, the man this way, he get everything necessary for push we country go before. Okay? He get the ability for bring people then together. And not only bring people then together, he want, you know, build, you know, the social fabric, the economic fabric, the political fabric, Nasalo. What do I mean by that? Education, abysmal. It will develop education. You know, job, no day, it will bring job. Industries, no day, it will bring industry. Healthcare systems, no day, it will bring healthcare systems. Okay? Transportation, poor, it will build up, you know, it will make Saloon vibrant. It will make people proud for being Sierra Leone and again. The most important thing, you know, corrupt. You know, corrupt. Because you know they come for come fat itself. It, like I said, they bring job then come, it will make people them feel proud for being Sierra Leone. And above all, it will make the international community come for can help Saloon for develop.
So if I can see, say, Kande Yunkela don't the ulcer, he don't already see the world.
Mm-hmm.
He don't already play leadership in the world. So we don't need to worry about, say, a little Sierra Leone, where small as much as we know, Kande Yunkela not go able to handle that one day.
Why not for able to learn? You know, when he been in at the UN, you know how many countries then in the UN? Over 199 countries.
Good.
Okay, Sierra Leone, that's small, very speck, you know, 7 million. This man mean they deal with billions of people there. And it changed the trajectory, you know, of the industrialization of the world. Because Naina have been the head of United Nations Industrial Development Organization. And not only that, it bring energy. In the Secretary General, in chief, you know, spokesperson, and mind development. For energy in the world, and still is.
All right, we're going to go on commercial right now. I thank you very much, Mr. Kabia.
It's a pleasure, sir.
Thank you.
Okay,
thank you very much. Yeah.
Just there is this change, and there is I still love the party, but I am totally opposed to the leadership. The way the leadership Now there's a lot of violence in the party, no respect for women, corrupt practices everywhere. I cannot believe a party can be that corrupt and then try to change my nation. So I chose to leave them this week.
So this has been in the works, or this is, you just decided to come out currently?
Well, what you know is in politics, things evolve. It's not just one incident, it's an accumulation. I had joined others before to try to get constitutionality, respect for the constitution within the party, a level playing field, and people just don't want that. And when I see what is going on now, time is running out, and there's the urgency of now. Our nation is suffering. Poverty is deepening. Over 70% of that population is in extreme poverty. Ebola decimated the country. I just believe that we cannot be playing kitchen politics in a party as to who is more dominant. What is important is the need to move out and create a new platform for Sierra Leoneans, progressives, to have a free expression of political interest. And then we compete to change the nation, convince the young generation that they ought to be better and they must be better. They must be as good kids in Ghana, in Rwanda, in other African countries where we've seen change and progress. What I see now worries me in Sierra Leone. And I think because of the urgency of now, 6 months before the election, that I chose to have separate ways with my father's SFPP.
I know that you have an extensive United Nations background, top positions there. How does that come in your expertise in the United Nations experience? How does that come into play with your campaign or you being president or your government?
I believe that has enriched me a lot. I spent almost 20 years.